Good evening, teacher.
Hello, how are you? Glad
More
to see you again.
More Ernest.
Elizabeth.
Yes, teacher.
Good evening, teacher.
Teacher, ahora solo voy a estar de oyente hoy. No me vaya a mandar a los grupos.
Okay.
Teacher, es que estoy mal de salud. Me he conectado. Sí, me he conectado solo para que no me vayan a cobrar.
Okay.
Sí, sí, imagínese, no me estuve conectando cuando estaba cuidando a mi hermano en el hospital y ahora me ha dado una gripe.
Le vamos a pedir que esté con mascarilla.
¿Cómo?
Le vamos a pedir que use mascarilla para que no nos pase la gripe.
Pero si se las pasara, tal vez me diera menos fuerte a mí.
Ah, bueno. Okay.
Good evening.
Hello, Ana Beatriz.
Hello, teacher.
How are you?
I'm fine, teacher. And you?
I'm fine, too.
Teacher, y cuando yo le dije more or less, es correcto. More or less.
More or less.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
¿Cómo se pronuncia?
More or less.
More or less.
Aunque prácticamente, talking about my case, I never used that kind of expression.
Pues sí, okay. Como usted dijo que eso sonó.
Yeah. But sometimes it's better when somebody says, well, I don't feel well today. I feel sick. Yeah, something like that.
Mm.
But in an informal way, maybe you can. Use it.
Mm. Okay, teacher.
Good evening, everybody.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
is the weather now in your areas? Tell me. Will it look like it's going to rain or not?
In my
no, teacher.
Funny.
Everything okay?
Hello, teacher. How are you?
Nice. What about you?
Yes, sir.
Excellent, excellent, sir.
Ready?
Yes, just waiting. The crew. Esperando la tripulación del avión y vámonos.
Que suban a bordo.
Yes.
Good evening, everybody.
Hello.
Good evening. Nombre de la danza.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you, everybody?
Waiting, waiting for you, sir.
Okay. Elizabeth, I do see you.
Jesus.
I do see you too.
Por eso que le jalan las orejas y se lo llevan temprano.
I'm sorry, teacher. Sorry. Yesterday, the last day presentation, village. Okay, I have a client the last time. Me da los documentos. Okay.
Okay. Excelente.
Because here I am, teacher.
Okay. Here am I. Here am I. Okay, let us see the attendance now. Please take a look at the attendance. Let me see. I got it. There is something here. I don't know what's happening here. Okay, I got it. Ana Beatriz, are you there?
Present.
Okay, you are present. Thank you. Blanca Elizabeth.
Present.
Ahí está. Carlos Alfredo Portillo. Carlos.
He is sleeping, teacher.
Maybe he's sleeping. Porque no lo veo por ningún lado. Okay, Carlos Antonio. Cristian Ernesto.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Claudio.
Present, teacher.
Denise, Grisel.
Present, teacher.
Eso, ahí está. Edwin. Bueno, Edwin ya no se conecta. Elmer. No quiere. Amber. Amber. Oh. Okay, it's not here too. Let me see. Elizabeth Martinez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Gonzalo. Gonzalo. Bueno, Gonzalo nos abandonó. Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Regresó.
I'll be back, teacher.
Ah, regresará entonces. Luis Manuel Muñoz. Luis Manuel. También toda la semana no lo he visto. Elena Guadalupe. ¿No? Nelson. Nelson.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay. Welcome. Omar Francisco.
Present, teacher.
Eso, siempre. Oscar.
Present.
Walter Aramis.
Present, teacher.
Ahí está. Jenny.
Present, teacher.
Ah, ahí está.
Yes.
Ustedes decían que no iba a estar. Ana Judith, Carlos Javier.
Present, teacher.
Ah, ahí está, bien. José Eduardo Guzmán.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Juan Carlos Rivas.
Present, teacher.
Carla Marisol. Carla Marisol. Bueno, Carla Marisol. Nos quedamos ahí esperando a Carla Marisol y no apareció. Okay, in order to start this class, we are going to remember how we are going to use the last topic, may and might. Okay, somebody want to give me some examples that you remember that we studied yesterday? No, or sí. Uh-huh. I'm waiting.
We use may and might.
Yeah. Well, give me some sentences that you remember.
May the force be with you.
Try to remember, please. Hay alguien que está intentando conectarse, pero no puede, dice Bueno, la señal está, no está tan buena, quizás por algunos sectores. Recuerden que durante el proceso, por eso se les pasa a, se les pasa lista varias veces, ¿no? Para que ustedes puedan tener la oportunidad, si por alguna razón no estaban, puedan, ¿cómo se llama?, responder en determinado momento. ¿Estamos claros? Sí, ¿verdad? Ok. Okay, in order to remember what we were talking about, it, I'm going to send you a link. Le voy a enviar un link por ahí. Rapidito para que hagamos un ejercicio. Y tratemos de recordarnos. Recuerden que solamente para medir a para medir el nivel de lo que se estuvo haciendo. Solo les voy a pedir que a la hora de estarlo haciendo muteen sus micrófonos para no tener ninguna referencia.
Perdón, Cher, ¿y eso al grupo lo ha mandado?
Sí, ahorita. Ahorita le llega. Recuerden tener en silencio su micrófono, por favor. Solo queremos ver solamente que se haga el repaso. Cada uno de ustedes lo va a hacer. Tranquilitos. Do you have it? Yes. ¿Lo tienen?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Okay, lo hacemos entonces a la actividad en creo que un par de minutos.
Teacher, y aquí, teacher. Estamos jugando con otro.
Ahorita. Permítame que ya le digo qué vamos a hacer. Okay, in this moment, what we are doing is just an exercise in order to remember the last class, the previous class that we have.
Y ese es un juego, teacher. ¿Cómo es eso? Teacher, ¿y aquí a dónde tengo que meterme o darle clic?
Okay, thank you. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Okay, don't worry about the result because it is just to remember the activity. It's just to refresh your memory. Teacher. Okay. Later on now you are going to get familiar with these kinds of activities, and that way we are going to remember exactly about some topics, you know. Okay, let us continue because now is okay, we are going to talk about Gutekun Life today. We already talked about May and Might. And now let us talk about this question. Okay, what would you do for the customer if a product you offer is not in good condition? I need that you write down three solutions for it. What would you do for the customer if a product you offer is not in good condition? Look for a solution. I need that you write down three solutions. ¿Se comprende la pregunta, sí?
Sí, pero está difícil cuando la gente no está brava.
Yes, of course, I know, but you need to look for three solutions.
I use the warranty, teacher. The chain product or repair.
Ah, okay. Somebody else, please. Piense. Impossible solution.
Why do you say regalía?
Like to give a present?
Digamos, por ejemplo, en los centros comerciales, aparte de ofrecerle, por ejemplo, la lavadora le da...
And you offer something extra, right?
Ajá, ofrecer algo extra.
Yeah, okay. It's like a prize.
Maybe offer like a prize.
Yeah. Or maybe some market, they offer a bonus. They can give you like $10 or $20 and you can go to a supermarket to buy something. Yeah, all depend. Okay, tell me. I need that you tell me, I'm waiting.
No entiendo.
¿Será que no me comprendieron la pregunta? That's maybe possible.
No.
Huh? What would you do for the customer? ¿Qué haría usted para el cliente if a product you offer is not in good condition? Si el producto que usted le ofrece no está en buenas condiciones. Try solution.
No había entendido la pregunta. I offer the low price.
Ah, low price and a discount.
Yes.
Discount, okay. Okay, Grisel, where are you? I don't see you. I saw you with your hand up. Ah, it's there. Tell me, Grisel.
One solution for me is for that is in offer. darle un porcentaje, that percent of, how do you say descuento?
Discount.
Discount. Solamente, digo yo, es una de las soluciones.
Ok, could be. Be a solution. Mario, please, Mario.
The other solution may be low price.
Give a low price, okay. It look like a discount.
Or discount.
Teacher, in food restaurant, they give a dessert, creo que se dice postre.
Talking about a restaurant?
En un restaurante, si hay algo que a uno no le gusta, le dan un postre.
Yeah, they can switch it to a dessert.
Dessert.
Yeah.
Teacher, maybe product change?
Okay, Carlos.
Yes, teacher, one call be to jive another product at half price for the purchase of that.
The half price, the 50% off. 50% off.
Okay. Por la, quizás por la compra de producto, no sé, ofrecerle uno con mitad de precio, cierto porcentaje.
Okay, okay.
Para que se anime a comprar.
We are having problem with the connection because I can hear you very well. Okay, somebody else, please, somebody else, tell me.
Me, teacher.
Tell me, sir.
Okay, teacher, in my case, I tell to my customer, explain to the customer the condition of the product.
Okay.
And if he wants it that way, he can improve the price and give him an extra gift.
An extra gift, okay.
An extra gift. Okay.
Somebody else, please.
Me, teacher. No mira mi manita.
Dígame, Elizabeth.
Entonces, me dice así. Did you try it? Menor precio, ¿cómo se dice? No,
low price.
Low price. Y offer.
Offer a discount.
Offer discount.
Yeah, could be or offer something extra. Okay. What else?
Me, teacher.
Tell me.
For me, it's good addition to teacher. Es una buena atención al cliente. No.
Okay.
And me, teacher, shoot the product for another branch.
Ah, for another branch, okay. What else?
I think the change the product for the client.
Okay. You can change it for a better one.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Well, suddenly what happened is that if you have a problem with the product, what they said, okay, take a look at the, let me see the guarantee, and we are going to send it to repair it. And you know, that usually happens here. Maybe in another country they have different options, but here in El Salvador is totally different. Okay, somebody else, please. Tell me.
Two for one.
What else? No, no me han comprendido la pregunta o no.
Cristian. Vuelvo a hacer, teacher, please.
Maybe other solution is one gift card.
Ah, or gift card. Okay, nice.
Algún coupon, any coupon for the other product.
Okay, excellent.
One membership. Maybe.
Membership.
It depends of company.
Well, depend on the company, membership or something like that. Excellent. Okay, somebody else want to say something about it? No?
Teacher, also change the product or different product, the sales price.
Ah, okay. Okay. And then you can say, okay, I would change the product. I would offer another option. Well, that is the expression that I need that you use. Okay. Somebody else want to say something? No? Okay, let us talk about how we are going to use good and good life. That is our main topic for this class. We are going to use good light to express requests or proportion more kindly. Good is a modal auxiliary verb, and when it is used with light, good light form a request or proposition in a polite way. In this structure, the form is always the same, even for the third person of singular. But I would like to share with you some info that explains better this topic. I need that you pay attention to this, because in this way I'm going to talk about this, okay? Let me see, I got it here. I got it here. And later on, we are going to see the book. Okay, try to pay attention, please. Okay, we are going to talk about good and good luck. Okay, well, first of all, we are going to talk about good. And we are going to say that it's an auxiliary verb, a modal auxiliary verb. We use good mainly to talk about the past. Sometimes we can use it to talk about the future in the past, express the conditional mode. We also use good for another function, such as a present desire. In this case, we are going to use it that reason, by request and question, opinion or hope, wish and regrets. En este caso, nosotros quizá lo vamos a usar más como para expresar un deseo o una solicitud cortés, ¿no? The structure that we are going to use it is going to be this one. Subject plus the auxiliary good plus the main verb. Be careful, when I say main verb, I'm not saying infinitive. I'm saying main verb. Note that the auxiliary verb good is invariable. There is only one form, good. El no va a cambiar. The main verb is usually in the base form. Example, he could go. ¿Qué se comprendería, por ejemplo, cuando yo digo he could go?
Él iría.
Ah, okay. Okay. Okay, look at the basic structure again with positive, negative, and question sentence. We have a positive, the subject is going to be fair. I could, if we are going to use a negative, well, we are going to add it. But in this case, we are going to talk about positive. I could like tea if you are in a restaurant. Or if you say, I could like to have another product. Me gustaría tener otro product. If we are talking about negative, we said, she could not go, for example. And in question, we are going to put the auxiliary at the beginning. We are going to put subject, complement. Could you help? Okay, I need that you pay attention to this structure, positive, negative, and question. If you keep in mind the structure, it's going to be easy for you to create sentences. Okay, what about good life? We use the modal expression good life in English to talk about our desires and wants. Good life is a more formal way to say wants. Quiero que se comprenda esta oración. Good life is a more formal way to say wants. Tell me, what is the meaning? ¿Qué comprende?
Que es una forma más formal, valga la redundancia, de decir quiero o me gusta. Okay. Quisiera.
Me gustaría.
Le gustaría. Ok, le gustaría. Ok. Example one. I would like to take a trip. I would like to take a trip. Intero say I want to take a trip. I would like to take a trip. The second one said, Sandra and her husband would like to have a June wedding. And the number three, Carl, would like a raise, but he's too nervous to ask his boss. Carlos quiere un aumento, pero él está nervioso de preguntárselo a su jefe. Okay, would like can be used for either present or future desires. In the present tense, on general desire, I could like a house by the ocean. They would like to improve their English. The student would like to take a break. But when we talk about desire for the future, I could say I would like to take an Italian class someday. Me gustaría tomar una. Si una clase de italiano algún día, you are talking about the future. My family would like to visit San Diego soon. Yep. The form of would like is this. Okay, in the expression would like, which word is an auxiliary and which word is a verb? The auxiliary is good and the verb is like. This means that you can use good like with any subject in English. It is not necessary to change good. No vamos a hacer ningún cambio, se va a mantener para cualquiera de los pronombres. Good like can be followed by a noun or a verb. If you want to use a verb after the expression good like, it must be in the infinitive. Okay, ojo con esto. Cuando usamos good like, ahí sí vamos a usar la forma. The infinitive is equal to say two plus the simple form of the verb. In English, we say, I could like to win the lottery. Not, I could like win the lottery. ¿Le prestan atención al ejemplo? Sí. Si solo fuese, si no tuviese like, ¿cómo sería?
I can.
I
could win the lottery. Ok, ojo con esta palabra, se las he venido repitiendo muchas veces. Con relación a could, con good, la L es muda. Bueno. Good. Ok. In this case, I could lie. Okay, contraction with good. The American often use contraction in English, especially when speaking. Pronouns can be contracted with good to make the following. I, you, will, they, should, he'd, like. And we need to take care about this. Tenemos que tener cuidado. Dígame, Carlos.
Sorry, teacher. Solo tengo una pregunta. Usted dice esta palabra good también se puede utilizar como que decir a mí me gustaría, yo quisiera. Que aunque es un auxiliar, recuerdo que también en la clase anterior habíamos enseñado también una palabra que es un auxiliar que también implica para desear o para querer. Entonces, ¿en qué momento podríamos ocupar cualquiera de estos auxiliares?
Ok, ¿alguien más levantó la mano? En la diapositiva anterior expliqué algunos usos. No me confundan, por ejemplo, cuando aparece la palabra sola, good, y cuando ya aparece good like. Explicamos en la anterior, me voy a regresar, porque quiero que quedemos muy claros en esto. Aquí. Dije que good life, we use the modal expression good life in English to talk about our desire and wants. Pero cuando estoy usando las dos expresiones, good life is more formal way to say want. Si nos queda clara esa parte, entonces sí podemos comprender la diferencia. Que cuando yo tengo la combinación de good life, es una forma más formal de decir yo quiero algo, ¿no? No sé si me voy a entender de esa forma.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Let me see. ¿Dónde estamos? Okay, the form
teacher.
Of... Hello.
I'm present. I believe that my partner prefer toward the last class could when you said that que podíamos ocuparlas para desear, pero usted explicó que era de desear, o sea, como un deseo hacia alguien más.
Hacia alguien más.
Creo que...
Ah,
pero, ajá, pero, y would es acerca de lo que uno quiere, o sea, de decir sí, pero, nosotros, de lo que queremos nosotros.
Yeah, I got it. Pero en ese caso...
No estoy segura, yo creí que a eso se refería el compañero.
Sí, pero en ese caso, cuando yo dije que era para desearle algo a alguien, era May. I remember that.
No. Okay.
Okay. In the expression would like, which verb in an auxiliary and which verb is at there. Okay, we already talked. Okay, tell me.
Teacher, este es, le voy a preguntar, pero en español. Es que creo que el compañero se refiere a que también a mí me enseñaron que would like es me gustaría. Siempre va a ir como me gustaría, pero no algo que quisiera. Quizás algo que quisiera, pero en una forma que... Me gustaría ir a algún lugar.
Yeah.
O me gustaría hacer una fiesta. Entonces, es algo que lo quiere, pero...
Es un deseo.
Es algo que está deseando hacer.
Yes. Okay, for example, we have... take a look at the sentence number one. Marla wants to find a better paging job. Okay, how we are going to say it using good like? ¿Cómo sería usando good like? Marla?
Maybe Marla would like to find a better paying job.
Marla would like to find a better paying job, okay? Simple as that. Okay. Number two, they want to buy a new car soon.
They would like to buy a new car soon.
Ah, okay.
I would like a new.
What about number three? I want a new. More comfortable sofa.
I would like a new, more comfortable sofa.
Oh, okay, 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 okay. And also, I need that you take a look at the contraction that we can use it. In this case, I use the same there. We often use contraction with good. Pronouns can be contracted with good to make the following. We already talked about this. We could, will, they, you, it, she. And we have, for example, right here, I instead of say I would visit France than Japan, and you sure that the way that you are going to pronounce it, okay? But take a look at the manual that we have. Let us see the manual. What it tell us about it. Okay, hold on a second. Hold on. I can't see it. I have a lot of documents open. For that reason, it's difficult sometimes to get the relevant. Okay, I guess it's page 24. If you have your material, you can see it there. I got it here. Okay, I got it here. I got it here. How we are going to use good and good light too. Okay, take a look at the examples. As I told before, the structure said that we are going to use the subject, then we are going to use good, and then the waveform of the verb. In this case, I can say, I could change this product. Yeah, or he goodbye there again. We couldn't stay in the place. And in a question form, will you give me your information? Now, based on this example, what can you tell me? What is the meaning in Spanish, if you want to say it, in order that you can understand what we are talking about? I could change this problem.
Maybe. Quiero cambiar este producto.
Me cambiaría este producto.
Ah, ok. Entonces, no es una regla general, pero logremos entender entonces que si un verbo tiene la palabra good antes del verbo, generalmente
me podría.
Estaría siendo la terminación de ería. ¿Sí?
Cambiaría este producto.
Este caso, por ejemplo, dice he could buy there again. Él
podría.
Compraría.
Él iría a comprar.
Volvería a comprar.
Bueno, ya nos metimos en problemas de. Nos metimos en problemas de traducción ahí. For that reason, se llamaron right to. Okay, but the most important is that you understand how we are going to use it. But okay, now switch and to the right side, and we are going to take a look about good light too. In this case, I good like to change this product. The meaning is totally different. ¿Cómo diría ella en español? I good like to change this product.
Cambiar este producto. Quisiera cambiar este producto.
Teacher, pero es que tiene I, es y
me,
eso me confunde porque al principio tiene I.
O me gustaría cambiar este producto.
Yo quiero cambiar este producto.
I would like to change. Me gustaría, you know, porque acordémonos que en español es sumamente diferente cómo usamos los pronombres, ya van implícitos. Cuando dice me, se refiere a mí. I would like to change this product. Or he would like to buy there again. Sí, a él le gustaría comprar ahí de nuevo. They couldn't like to come back here. A ellos no les gustaría regresar. Would you like to get a refund? Sí, le gustaría un reembolso por lo que pagó.
Teacher, pero no nos dijo la traducción de la primera good sin el like to.
De esta.
Sí,
I would change this product. I already told you.
No.
Even I ask you how you translate, I said. Les pregunté.
Yo le dije, teacher, que todos traducimos y nadie tradujo lo mismo, entonces no sabemos.
Nadie pegó.
Correcto.
Ok, generalmente ahí podríamos decir de varias formas, ¿sí? En este caso, por ejemplo, yo lo que les expliqué a ustedes fue y les dije, Una de esas formas podría ser que cuando would está antes del verbo, hace la terminación ría. ¿Se recuerdan que dije eso?
Sí.
Ah, entonces, sí, yes. Entonces ahí diría, yo cambiaría
este producto. Cambiaría este producto.
Sí.
Cambiaría este producto.
Yo lo expliqué.
Sí, sí, es cierto. Gracias por explicarlo.
Lo que pasa es que el espero fue muy rápido, por eso no lo logró escuchar, compañera.
¿Será que yo hablo tan rápido?
No, teacher, no mucho.
Él hizo sleepy.
¿Ah? Yes. ¿Será eso? Ok. Hold on a second. Ok. Siga pensando ahora. Siga
la pensando. Lista antes que me
sí, ahorita eso voy. Ya la alarma sonó. Ahorita. I got it here. Ok, let me see. Ana Beatriz. Elizabeth.
Present.
Elizabeth.
Present.
Alfredo Portillo. Carlos Alfredo a la una. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Cristian.
Present, teacher.
Claudio Iván. Claudio.
Present.
Edwin.
Present, teacher.
Okay, hold on. I say Claudio, Grisel.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Edwin? Is there? No? Elmer? Amber? Elizabeth Martinez.
Present, teacher.
Gonzalo. Gonzalo. Luis.
Present.
Luis Manuel. Luis Manuel. No. Elena Guadalupe.
I am here, teacher.
Omar.
Present, teacher.
Oscar.
I'm here.
Walter.
Present, teacher.
Jenny.
Present, teacher.
Ana Judith. Carlos Javier.
Present, teacher.
Jose Eduardo.
Present, teacher.
Juan Carlos.
Present.
Y Carla.
Present.
Apareció Carla.
A mí no me lo dijeron.
¿Really? Nelson.
Nelson, sí.
Let me see. Where are you? Nelson Gabarrete.
Oye, María. No.
Sí, ya está. Está después de Elena María, sí.
De María.
Sí, ahí está.
De Elena María, no.
Ok. Yeah, ok, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, sir. Lo siento mucho.
Teacher, don Alex ya no está con nosotros.
Excuse me?
Don Alex ya no está con nosotros.
No. I don't have any Alex in my group. And I have some example. He couldn't lie any stem. She couldn't lie to exchange any euro for pounds. They couldn't lie any ticket for bus. 89, you know, in that way. But the question maybe is this, how we are going to use good and good lie too when we are talking about imagine that the question that I asked you at the beginning, if a client argue about a product, how you are going to use good or good light too, or if you are going to ask for a new product, how you are going to do it. That is the main point, how we are going to deal with this expression. ¿Cómo vamos a usar estas expresiones? Uh-huh. Tell me. Tell me. Okay, imagine that we have this. Okay, take a look at this. Pay attention about the exercise number two. Well, right here we have something that is the name of the company, Weatherlux Inc. And we have all the information, the sender name and the address. And okay, and also we have some notes. Number one said, please note, Weatherlux customer satisfaction guarantee is 90 days from the day of purge. Number two, retain a copy of your record, enclose the original with the merchandise. And number three said, use one line per item. All quantity are to be reported in each space. All item return will require the original order number recorded on the form so credit can be processed. And you have this number, the stock detail, we have the reason code, we have some letter ID that is the dissatisfactions, double P that is product performance, and also we have the item number, quantity, the date of purchase, and the order number and the relevant reason. In this case, in relevant reason, said that is missing parts. Le faltan algunas partes. Okay. Based on this information, I need that you work in exercise number three. We have two questions. And we are going to check the refund form to answer the question, and then we are going to compare it. The number one said, what are the reasons the customer wants a refund? ¿Cuál es la razón por la que el cliente quiere reembolso? Could the customer get the refund and why? Okay. We'll have 3 minutes to answer these two questions. If you don't have your material, you can make a screenshot now and start working on it. Your notebook, please. Okay, I want to see, I want to see. Only two questions. Solo son dos preguntas.
¿Qué página es, perdón?
It is 25. Page 25. Por lo visto no hicieron el screenshot.
No.
Okay, ahí lo tenemos. Ahí lo tenemos. Dissatisfaction and product.
Está en el folleto de aprendizaje.
Yes, it is, sir.
Ah, okay, okay, yeah, 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 ya lo encontré, ya lo encontré. Okay.
Ah, okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
Where are you? Okay. Vamos a contar.
Yeah, answer the two questions. Now, please, now. As soon as you finish, just let me know, please. You got the info there in order to give an answer. Okay, tell me. Do you finish? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, give me your answer.
The number one is garantía.
Okay, the whole answer, please. I don't know what is happening with my system, but suddenly my camera stopped working. I don't know why. Será señal baja de internet que mi cámara se está deteniendo mucho, no sé por qué. Okay, give me the answer, please.
The number one is garantía, teacher.
Okay, the question said, what are the reasons the customer wants a refund? What is the reason?
I think so, others even with the product, maybe the product is damaged or doesn't work as expected.
Okay. You have it in the info. The exercise two. Somebody else, please tell me.
Satisfaction.
Tell me, Elizabeth.
la pregunta uno. Yes. Yo creo. Y el customer wants a refund for missing part, porque le falta es. No se entendiese.
Okay, take a look at the question.
Dissatisfaction, product, performance, teacher.
Ah. Repeat again, please.
What are the reasons the customer wants a refund?
Okay.
Is dissatisfaction and product performance.
Okay. The reason are dissatisfaction and product performance, because we have it in the reason code. We have the answer for that question. Ahí tenemos la respuesta en donde dice the reason code.
Okay.
What about the second one?
Not true.
Yeah. Could the customer get the refund? Why?
Number two.
Tell me. Tell me.
You don't know what's it, hello teacher. And this Goldie customer had the phone. Yes, well, for a product the does not complete. The product no complete.
Ahí hay una palabra clave en the relevant reason.
Mm-hmm.
Ahí aparece.
The product are incomplete.
For the reason is missing part. Ah, okay. Ordenemos entonces la respuesta. Si la pregunta dice, could the customer get the refund? And why? The answer would be better. Sería mejor. You say, the customer would get the refund because, ¿qué más? Because there are
missing parts.
Because there are some missing part of the product. Ah, okay. Excelente. Do you get it? It sounds much better that way. I'm going to repeat the answer. In order that you can compare with your own, para que usted la pueda comparar con la respuesta que usted tiene ahí. Okay. If the question said, si la pregunta dice, oiga bien, would the customer get the refund and why? ¿Obtendría el reembolso, el cambio, el cliente? ¿Y por qué? And the answer could be that the customer would get the refund because there are some missing parts of the product. Esa sería la respuesta. Is that clear? No? No está claro.
No.
No está claro. Let me share with you the question. Vaya, observemos aquí la pregunta número 2. Dice, could the customer get the refund and why? ¿Obtendría el reembolso, el cambio, el cliente y por qué? Ahí le está preguntando las razones, el por qué.
Por la garantía, teacher.
Yeah.
De 90 días.
It is cost, the guarantee has to be with that, okay? And the main reason is why? What is the relevant reason? Because there are some missing parts. Porque le hacen falta partes. Esa es la conclusión más importante quizá ahí en cómo se llama en ese proceso, ¿no? Yes. Okay. Any questions so far from here? ¿Alguna pregunta hasta aquí? No? Yes? And we already talked about good and light too. Okay, before to go to another topic, let us complete exercise number 5. We are going to get exercise number 5. Following a statement or question. Okay. In number 1, I would like to. How you are going to complete this? Number 2, Mr. Trujillo wouldn't. Ah, okay. Number 3, would she? Number 4, would like to. Number 5, she wouldn't. There is a misspelling. En las 5 y las 6 hay un misspelling ahí. ¿Ya lo vieron? Hola.
Yes, in the 5 say word.
Yeah, ahí hay un error de dedo.
Error.
En las 2.
Even word. Word. Ah, ok, sí.
Sí, ¿verdad?
Le pusieron mundo.
Bueno, para que vea que...
No, no, ni mundo.
Para que vea que también los grandes se equivocan.
Es... Falta la U. En vez de la E.
Yes.
Aquí lo arreglo.
Ahorita lo arregla usted.
Okay. Sí, voy a hablarlo en ese.
Okay, what I need is that you complete the statement or the question based on the example that you have about.
She will know. Okay.
Okay, as soon as you finish, you are going to share with me. Okay, if you want si no lo tiene, puede hacer una captura para luego. I want to see your faces. Hagamos captura si no lo tiene, por favor.
Listo, teacher.
Excellent. Okay, let us work on it now, please. Don't forget the structure that we need to follow. No olvidemos la estructura que vamos a seguir. No, no, que no le dé sueño, que no le dé sueño.
Aquí le mando coffee. El complemento lo que vamos a poner es según la oración, dijeron.
Ahí
según nosotros que queramos poner.
Sí, claro. Ahí va a depender de su punto de vista lo que usted quiera escribir.
Ok.
I would like to. For example, I'm going to say this. Pero eso significa que nadie la va a escribir. No va a decir, no, no, ya la tenía. I would say, I would like to have. I would like to have a better product, for example. No, mejor yo no le sigo dando ejemplos porque me van a decir, no, ya los tenía. Esos, yo sí, ya los tenía. No, 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 no. I'm going to wait. As soon as you finish, just let me know, please. Solo son dos preguntas, only two questions, no more than two. Okay, tell me. Tell me, please. Hello?
Quedó solo.
Yes.
Y eran dos preguntas, no seis.
Son seis preguntas, teacher.
Yes, you have six.
Ah, okay.
No. Hold on. No. I'm right. Preguntas son dos.
In the four sentences.
Yeah. Sí, claro.
Yes.
Claro. Tienes razón. Preguntas son dos.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Solo las preguntas vamos a hacer.
No necessary, but.
Ah,
yes. What you like to?
Ajá.
Okay. I'm finished, teacher.
Okay. Would you like to share with us?
Teacher.
It is number?
It's the number one. I would like to ask for a favor.
I could like to
ask you a favor.
Ah. Okay, next one. Number two.
Me, teacher.
Do it.
Okay. Mr. Trujillo wouldn't give me information for homework.
Mr. Trujillo wouldn't give me permission to do my homework. Acordémonos que para qué situaciones vamos a usar el good like to. Okay. Somebody else?
Me. Mr. Trujillo wouldn't lie to dinner here.
Couldn't lie to dinner here. Okay.
Yo lo tengo así, Mr. Trujillo would not go to work.
Wouldn't go to work.
Yes.
Okay. Maybe he's sick or feel bad. Somebody else?
British one should quit a good employee the offer.
Number three.
Could you repeat the question, please?
Would she win a good employee offer?
Would she win
a good employee offer? Podríamos darle premio por buen empleado.
Ah, would she win?
Uh-huh. A good employee the award.
Okay. Employee prize. Okay. Next, please.
Number three, yo la tengo así. Will she dance in the star? ¿Podría ella bailar en el escenario?
Good. She.
Yes. Dance in the star.
Dance in the scenery. Okay. Se me olvidan de las empresas ustedes, ¿verdad? And just talk about different places.
Solo ahí pasamos metidos, teacher.
Ah, okay. It's part of your life, you know. Algunos hasta sueñan que están ahí con los empleados. Y otros sueñan que están en sus trabajos.
24-7.
24-7, ok.
24-7 no tengo que hacer el trabajo, me solo metido ahí.
Fisher, una pregunta. En el would she, el verbo lleva S al final o no se utiliza la S en este caso?
No. I remember.
En este caso va normal, pero dice.
Yes. Sí, porque ya el good es el auxiliar.
Yo auxiliar, por eso.
Yes, okay. Okay, maybe we are going to switch the activity. Porque ya veo de que algunos no le encuentran la respuesta a las preguntas. Entonces, we are going to switch the activity. And what we are going to do is that, let me see. Okay. And you are going to work in pair. And you are going to think in a situation in which one product was not working in a company. And you had to offer some solution to it. I don't know if you got my message. You are going to work in couples. I'm going to create a breakout room. And you are going to create a conversation. The conversation has to be based on you are the seller, ustedes como que fueron los vendedores. Le vendieron un producto a una compañía y ese producto no está funcionando. Yes? And that person in shares, la persona encargada de compras is going to call you and ask for a refund of the product. And how you are going to deal with that. I need that you use good or good like too. You are going to ask some question. Yeah, at the beginning, somebody said, okay, Luis Alfonso is on the phone. How can I help you? Okay, I'm calling from my company. Do you remember the last time we bought a product of your company? I'm calling you because the product is not working the proper way. And I would like to have any solution. And you are going to start talking about that. ¿Se comprende?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me create the breakout room. Veamos ahorita, va a quedar uno de tres. Nueve, dos, serían...
Teacher, pero unos five minutes.
Unos 5 minutes.
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, veamos cómo están los grupos. Ah, okay, hay uno que me quedó de tres. Let me see. Got problem here. I got problem.
Hay un gallo que ya nos está cantando, teacher.
Yes, it's the neighbor.
Se amaneció.
Ya quiere que lo cocinemos, teacher.
Yeah, neighbor had a lot of animal here, you know.
¿De quién es ese gallo?
El sopón de fin de semana.
Cuando hagan gallo en chicha, me avisan.
Gallo en chicha.
It's good to know, it's good to know. Okay, estamos ahí. Ready? Okay, let us start. Remember, you can mention the name of your company, and also you can talk about the name of the product and the solution. And you are going to use good or good like too, based on that, please. I'm going to give you, let me see, it is enough. Okay, let us start with 3 minutes. And then we are going to, vamos a tener refill otra vez. Okay, let us do it now. Please go, 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 go. Claudio, go to room 4, please. Okay, in this moment, all the participants are talking about the product and the solution that they are going to look for applying the vocabulary study in this class. Okay, let us see what they think of this.
Eso no fueron tres minutos.
No, sí, chévere.
Fueron dos minutos.
Vamos a saludarnos, estábamos. Es divino.
Nelson. ¿Y cuántos Nelson fueron?
Diche.
Hello.
Diche. Nelson no se conectó, bueno, se conectó conmigo, pero no habló nunca. No sé si está por ahí, Nelson.
Sí, ahí está. Parece que tiene muteado el micrófono.
Muteado.
Nelson.
Hola, no, creo que este se ha tocado ahí, dice, yo tengo conectado dos dispositivos. Entonces me tocó con Omar.
Ah, dice, con dos dispositivos
el otro,
estaba,
yes, con dispositivo, uno en la compu para ver el, la otra es para el video y el audio que usa el teléfono.
Lo grande.
Yo creo que ahí se equivoca el teacher. Ah, ayer creo que también así pasó, también dejó por ahí a, no me recuerdo con quién me tocaba.
Let me see where you are. ¿Y estuvo con quién, Nelson?
Ahorita estuve con Omar.
Ah, o sea que José Eduardo se quedó solo.
Yes, teacher.
Ah.
Ahí estaba tratando de hacer ahí la compra y la venta de un solo.
Entonces la compra-venta.
Es compra-venta, está bien. Esa la firmo. La firma, la sellamos.
Okay, let me see. I don't know why.
Hey, DJ, qué rápido pasaron los minutos.
Yes. In a hurry.
Teacher, que no dijo que eran 5 minutos los que nos iba a dar.
6.
Sí. Solo aquí pasan rápido los minutos en el trabajo, quisiera que pasaran así.
No, con un cronómetro y se va a dar cuenta que se detiene, no camina.
No, pues sí, yo no sé. Lo contrario.
Es que el cronómetro del teacher va bien rápido.
Solo en los grupos y en la hora del almuerzo vuela el tiempo, ya de ahí.
Okay, I'm going, José Eduardo. I'm going to send you to another group because you are alone. Ahí que lo incluyan en el equipo 1, lo vamos a enviar.
Ok, teacher.
Para dejar a Nelson él solo porque él está riendo.
No,
como tiene dos dispositivos. Okay, let's do it now again, please, because I need all of you to participate and talk about. Okay, in this moment, all the participants are talking about how they are going to resolve the problem. That means that they need to give some solution using would or would like to. They are going to include that expression and they need to have enough time in order to create the conversation. For the reason, we need to wait. Okay, let's do now, please.
Teacher, 2 minutitos más o uno, vaya.
Only review and practice the conversation. 1 minute more.
The problem is that I give you the time that you request, and at the end, when I ask you to do it, some of you don't participate. I want believe in you. But the problem is that sometimes some of you don't want to do it in front of the class.
Qué rápido pasó el tiempo otra vez, bueno.
Así es.
Con Mr. Omar me tocó, teacher.
Ah, con Mr. Omar.
Mr. Okay. Omar Hernández. Ah, okay. Fue algo pequeñito que hicimos. Pero igual, que me diga que lo que hicimos, yo le voy a responder.
Ah, okay, okay. Start doing now, please.
Hello, Mr. Omar. Hello, Mr. Omar.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Nelson. My name is Omar Hernandez. The company is Casco Safety.
Oh, hello, Mr. Omar.
Our
goal, how many pieces are you needed?
I'll go precise all the product.
Okay, how many pieces are you needing?
I 25 missing part.
Oh, okay, Mr. Omar. Ladies and new product.
Okay, thank you, Mr.
Okay, can you finish, teacher?
Okay, I wonder how many times did you use good and good light too in the conversation?
I will not recite on the problem.
Ah, I couldn't. Okay. And Nelson?
Hello?
How many times did you use good or good light too? Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, somebody else, please.
No, Jenny.
Okay, Jenny.
With Carlos.
Okay, sorry. good afternoon. My name is Javier, and I have a complaint about a product that they sold me.
Hi, Carlos. My name is Jenny. Could you restart the air conditioner?
No, restarting it is not working.
Then I send the technician for the review the air conditioner. Will you receive the technical tomorrow?
Yes, perfect. Thank you, Jenny.
Okay, thank you. Carlos Antonio.
Okay, are you ready, Juan Carlos? Juan Carlos.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. How I can help you?
I would like to change this product.
The product has a problem.
Yes, the product is damaged.
You have the warranty?
Yes, of course.
Okay, then we change the product.
Thank you.
Okay.
I need that you take into account at the moment to ask questions. For example, if you are going to ask for warranty, you are going to use an auxiliary. Do you have with you the warranty certificate? Yeah.
Okay.
It sounds better. If you use an auxiliary, do you have the warranty certificate with you? Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I don't know. The first question that you asked, ¿cuál fue la primera pregunta que usted le hizo?
How can I help you?
No.
Una pregunta, ¿no? Que the product has a problem.
Ah, ok, pero sí.
Okay. Se puede usar el auxiliar, do you?
Sí.
Do you have a problem with the product?
Ah, ok, could be, but if you talk about the product in a specific way?
No specific.
That's general. For example, if you are talking about one, that's the product. Does your product have any problem?
Repeat, please.
Does your product have any problem? ¿Tiene su producto algún problema? Okay.
Okay.
Okay. It's better if you use auxiliaries.
Yes.
Okay, you take into account, please. Okay, somebody else, please. ¿Alguien más, por favor?
Me and Elizabeth, teacher.
Ah, ¿con quién, don Luis?
With Elizabeth.
Ah, okay, okay, go ahead.
Pero le comparto la conversación. Eli?
Yes.
Okay, start you.
You start.
You start.
Hi, don Luis. Yes. Hi, don Luis.
Hi, Eli, how are you? How can I help you?
I purchased a cell phone, but it does not work. And I would like to refund or change the product.
I'm sorry for the problem, but I will not refund. I would like to change the product if you accept.
Okay, I would like to change the phone.
Okay, I would like to receive you at 9 a.m. on Monday.
Okay, see you Monday, don Luis.
Okay, only that, teacher.
Okay, leave it that. Déjelo ahí. No me lo quite de ahí. Por favor. Aquí dice, I approach. Aquí tiene que ser pasado el verbo. Okay. And aquí, in this part, what you can say is, but I can refund you instead of use good. But I could not refund.
Where teacher? Sorry.
Right here.
Where?
Right here. I don't know if you see my mouse. Yeah, you need to have the past participle, the simple past of this verb. Which. And let me see what else. Ah, right here. I am sorry for the problem.
Or
I do sorry for the problem. No, do you emphasize it? Okay.
I am sorry.
You hear that?
I'm sorry for the problem. But
okay, thank you. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much. Okay, somebody else?
Thank you, Eli.
Yourself, it's your turn.
No sé si Carla no me aparece conectada. Carla Marisol.
I don't see her. Let me see. No, I don't see her.
Puedo leer ambas partes.
Yeah, because you are alone. At least that you can share the screen and somebody else can help you to read it. But if you have in your notebook, go ahead.
I'm in my notebook.
Okay.
Good morning. I would like to make the refund for this cell phone. And the other person, good morning. I'm Grisel. And tell me, what is your problem with your cell phone? Another person answered. I have the problem with the calls. I can hear nothing. Oh, okay. And the other person answered. We don't do refund after 1 month, but would you like to repair or change product? And other person answered.
I would like to give me money. And the other person, I'm sorry, I can't.
Okay, la antepenúltima, ¿cómo dijo?
Okay. I would like to give me money.
I could like you return my
like
money.
Like you give me money.
Return, okay. Return my money.
Okay.
Okay. Somebody else,
okay.
Please.
Only that.
Okay, thank you. Somebody else, somebody else. Nos hacen falta varios y hoy tienen que pasar todos.
Y si no, no termina la teacher.
Si no, no cerramos el business. Hey, okay, okay, I'm waiting. Ah, se dan cuenta lo que les dije. Me pedían más tiempo y al final, miren.
Nadie quiere participar.
Ahí está. Ya lo dijo Nelson. Ahí casi veo a alguien que levanta su mano y dice. Ah, bueno, ahí tenemos a Oscar. Ok, Oscar.
Blanca me dijo que no quería participar.
Ah,
¡qué mentiroso! Qué a esta hora les agarraron a mis niñas.
Yo estaba esperando que ella levantara la mano, pero...
La exhibió.
No, aquí a esta mentiras, hora les agarra bulla.
Son bromas, son bromas.
Yeah, I know that you are kidding.
Ok, starting. Hello, can I help you?
I am Blanca. Would you enterprise price and last week we bought a phone and it is defectuoso. I am unsatisfied.
Okay, no problem. Would you like to change the product?
Yeah, I like.
Okay, no problem. Could you give me the order numbers?
2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 9.
Perfect. We will proceed to the chain.
Okay, yeah.
Only that, teacher.
Okay, the last expression that you said, we will
proceed the change.
Ah, okay, okay. The process is the verb.
Process. Uh-huh. Procedemos.
Okay. Yeah. The procedure. To make a refund for the product. Okay. Somebody else, please. Me faltan varios. No. Okay. I remark that I give you the chance to participate, and some of you don't want to do it. Dejamos claro que les dimos la oportunidad de participar, y muchos no quisieron hacerlo. Okay, let me see the assistant now. Let me see. Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Blanca Elizabeth.
Present.
Carlos Alfredo Portillo Núñez. No se presentó el día de ahora. Carlos Antonio is there.
Present.
Cristian Ernesto is there. Cristian. Claudio Iván.
Present.
Cristian.
Present, teacher.
Edwin Balmore. Elmer. Amber. Francisca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Elizabeth Gonzalo. Bueno, Gonzalo como que ya no. Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Luis Manuel. Somebody knows something about Luis Manuel. No. Alguien que sea co-worker with him. Alguien que sea compañero de trabajo de él. No. María Elena.
I'm here, teacher.
Nelson.
I'm here, teacher.
Omar Francisco.
Present, teacher.
Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Walter.
Present, teacher.
Ahora no participó Walter. Jenny.
Present, teacher.
Ana Judith. Carlos. Javier.
Present, teacher.
José Eduardo.
Javier.
Juan Carlos Rivas. Carla Marisol.
Present, teacher.
Juan Carlos.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Juan Carlos.
I know this time is over. Time is over now. Okay, thank you. I do really appreciate that you be here with me. I hope to see you tomorrow. The person that was assigned for today is not present. A la persona que le correspondía hoy, la tutoría no está presente. Okay. Él se la perdió. Oh, ella, I'm not pretty sure what names. Okay. Thank you very much. Don't forget to get into the platform and resolve all the exercises that you have there. So please do it. And remember, tomorrow is going to be Friday.
Mañana. Salud, salud Blanquita.
Mañana será viernes y don Luis. Y don Luis tiene un dicho para el viernes, así que no lo diga ahora porque eso es, it's going to be tomorrow, okay?
Okay, teacher, tomorrow.
Okay, see you. Bye-bye. Good night.
Bye.
Good night.
Bye.
Good night.
Good night.
Good
night.
Bye, teacher.
Good night.
Bye.
Ah, good night, baby. Good night. Eso, ya aprendió, mire. Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Okay, as I told you, this day, the person that was assigned is not present. For the reason, what I'm going to do is just to reinforce the topic for today. And what I'm going to remember you is the way that you are going to use good and would like to. What I told you was that the good is an auxiliary verb, and that we are going to use it to express desire, polite request, and question, and sometimes opinions or hope. And try to keep in mind that in this case, we are using good in that way. And that after good, what we are going to use is a verb form. That means that we are not going to use infinitive. Keep in mind that. And when we use would like to, that means that If we are using to, that means that we are using infinitive. I would like to ask you, yeah? And it's different if you say, I could change this product. For example, okay, and try to keep in mind the structure. I told you, how is it? At the beginning, you are going to use the subject and then you are going to add the auxiliary, then this case good, and then you are going to put the member and the complement. And remember that if you are using good, that word is not going to change. That means that you can use it with a third singular person and you are not going to put inflection to the verb in that case. For example, you can say, he couldn't go, he could travel, and so on. And when we use it in a negative way, what we are going to add is not after good. For example, we can say she could not go. Yeah, that means that the word not is going to be in the middle of good and the verb. And when we ask question using good, what we are going is to switch the position and we are going to put the auxiliary at the beginning. And the question is going to start with good and then it's going to be the subject, good you, and then you are going to use the main verb in a base form. Will you help me? Yeah, could be in that way. And when we talk about good life, we are going to use it in a formal way, instead of say once. For example, somebody could say, I would like to take a trip, or I would like to go to Canada, for example. Okay, I guess that, what I told you that in this case, you are going to, after like, you are going to use to, and then the verb. I could like to tell you this. Okay, thank you very much for paying attention. I hope to see you tomorrow. Have a good night. Bye-bye.